If you design data dashboards, you might have heard the idea before that pie charts are bad. Pie charts do have some problems, but it's important to understand what they're bad at and why to avoid the issue. Because it's not just pie charts that have these problems. Remember, we use the metaphor of a dashboard from a car. You aren't meant to stare at it doing deep analysis. It's meant to be at-a-glance information so you can keep tabs on how the business is doing at a high level. If you stared at your car's dashboard while driving, you'd crash. So the info on a data dashboard should be really easy to understand and look at, rather than a big, complex visualization that you might spend minutes or hours exploring. So it comes down to how the human brain processes visual information. Certain kinds of visualizations are really compatible with how our brains work, and we start to make sense of them before we're even really paying attention. These are called preattentive features. So we're really accurate and efficient at comparing the length of things and their position in 2D space, but we're not so great at quickly or correctly estimating angle or area or color. Here's why pie charts are not very good for this sort of thing. They take numbers and encode them into slices of a circle. That means that the numeric information is shown by three things: the area, the angle of the slice, and the arc length of the outside circumference. So, of those three things, we're only good at estimating one of them, the arc length of the outside circumference. And it's easier to compare length on straight lines than curved ones, especially when they are not starting at the same spot. That means that pie charts are pretty bad when we need to compare numbers with any precision. If you only have a very few slices, and they're all of very different sizes, it can be okay, but it still takes more mental effort to make sense of them than a bar chart of the same information. Now think about how many pie charts are on a typical dashboard. It's not just one, usually. So the cumulative effect is that it's much harder to make sense of all of that than a simple bar chart. And since the numbers change constantly on a dashboard, we don't know if we're going to be dealing with slices that will all be very different sizes, or if it'll just be minute differences. And it's not just pie charts that suffer these challenges. Tree maps, where we show hierarchical information in a series of nested rectangles, are also really difficult. They encode numbers in the size of each rectangle, and remember, we're bad at estimating area. So are gauges, which take the car dashboard metaphor a little too literally. These use bars of the same total length and curve them so that we have to use the angle of the needle to make sense of them. Or stacked bar charts, which take one of the most reliable types of data visualizations, a bar chart, and make it much harder to read. Look at this one. For the top segment, is it getting bigger or smaller? How sure are you? So what can we use that works better? If it's a scenario where comparing numbers is important, use a bar chart sorted by length instead of a pie chart or a tree map. If you're showing whether a metric is on target or not, use a bullet graph instead of a curved gauge. Pie charts can be okay if you only have a very few slices. Exact comparisons aren't necessary, and the main takeaway is that one item is overwhelmingly larger than all of the others.